Welcome back to my channel, Being a Programmer. I am Rajashree and today we have to see controlling program flow in your PLPG SQL. In previous videos, we can see introduction to your RDBMS, after that the code structure of PLPG SQL, then the attribute variables, which are percent type and percent row type attribute variables. All previous videos are available on the channel and the link is provided in description box. So in this video we can see controlling program flow, how to control the program flow of PLPG SQL. So without any further ado, let's quickly get started. First of all, we see some history. So your PLPG SQL language is similar to your C language. Both structure are nearby similar. So in C language we can also use some controlling structures or how to control the program flow in C language. So we can use some loops or some conditional statements, which are if else loop, then nested if else, for loop, do while loop, and many more loops are used in your C language to control the program flow. And same as to here, in your PLPG SQL language we can use multiple program controlling program flow, which are conditional statement and control loops. There are two types, conditional statements and control loops, which are used to control the program flow in your PLPG SQL language. So we have to study both types, which are conditional and control loops, in depth. So first of all, we see the conditional statement in your PLPG SQL language, which is used to control your program flow or your function flow in PLPG SQL. So what are the conditional statements? So look at here, conditional statement specifies an action that should be executed until the condition specified within this statement is true. So conditional statement are those statement which perform some actions, which executed some statements which are provided in between code block until the given condition is true, and whenever the condition is false, our loop or our conditional statement is terminated, and this is your conditional statement. And same conditional statement we have to see in C programming, which is if else statement, and same here we can see if then statement. So both if then and if else are more 90% similar. So look at here, we can see the if then statement. So first of all, what is the if then statement? So this if then statement allows a user to specify a statement that should be executed if given condition evaluates true. So when we use if then statement, then this statement allow user to execute mentioned statements until your provided condition is true. Whenever condition false, we can terminate these if then statement. So we can see the syntax of if then statement, which is if keyword is used, after that we can provide a condition, and if this condition is true, then this then part is executed. After that then keyword, we mention some statements, and these statements are executed until this provided condition is true. Whenever this condition is false, then we can exit from these statements. And look at here, when provided condition is false, then we can execute this else part or these else part statements here. So this is your if then syntax is here. So we start the if then statement by using if keyword, and we end this loop or this conditional statement by using end if statement. This is your PLPG SQL if then statement. So we can see the example. So we can create a function by using create function clause. Function name is demo. Then we cannot use or cannot pass any argument to this demo function. After that, by using this demo function, we return some value, and that's why return statement is here. We return integer type value. That's why we use statement create function demo returns integer as. After that, apostrophe is here, and then your declaration part is started by using declare keyword. And then we can see we have to declare two variables. First variable is x variable having data type integer, and for that x variable we can assign a value 50, and then we can declare another variable y having data type integer, and our declaration part is end or exit from declaration part, and new part is started, which is a procedural logic. Sorry for the noise. Begin block is started here. So in this begin block we can write a procedure, and first of all we use conditional statement here. So for conditional statement we can use if then statement, and first of all we use if keyword, then our condition is here. Condition, what is the condition? X is greater than 30. We provide x a value which is a 50, and we use here a condition x is greater than 30, and if it is true then we can execute this then part, which is y equal to x plus 2. We have to assign a value to y which is x plus 2. So if x is greater than 3 then our y value is x plus 2, but if condition is false then we can execute this else part, and this else part we can assign y to 0, and then we can end this if statement. And after that our begin part which will be started, that means our procedural block is ended by using this end statement, and then your language PLP JSQL, and this is your if then statement, how to use if then statement in function. So our next part, in conditional statement there is only one type, which is if then statement. So conditional statement is ended here. After that we can see our next part which control the program flow, which is control loops, and there are three types of loops: basic loop, while loop and for loop. Both three loops are similar to your C language loops. First of all we see the basic loop. So what is the basic loop? So basic loop is an unconditional loop. In this loop we can execute some statements, and then we check the condition whenever we terminate this basic loop. And that's why we know this basic loop as an unconditional loop. First of all we use a loop keyword to indicate we can start the basic loop. After that loop is executed until the exit condition. So exit, to indicate the exit condition we can use exit keyword, and these exit keyword followed by when. After that when we can provide a condition, and when the condition is true then that means we have to exit from this basic loop. And for example we can see how to use this basic loop. So here we can create a function demo returns integer as, that means demo function returns integer type value, and for that we can create function, and after that declaration part is here. So in this declaration part we can declare x variable having integer data type and assign a value 2. After that we can start our code block, actual code block, by using begin statement, and after that begin statement we can use loop keyword which indicates we can start the basic loop by using loop keyword. After that here are some statements, which is x equal to x plus 2. Unconditional loop is here, and that's why we simply provide some expressions x equal to x plus 2, and whenever this basic loop terminated, so we can in next line we can provide exit keyword which shows whenever we have to exit from this loop, and when we exit, so when keyword is provided here, and after that when keyword we can provide the condition. Whenever x is greater than 20 then we can terminate from this basic loop, and this is the basic loop syntax here. After that end loop statement is here, which will tell us our basic loop is terminated here, and after that we can return the x value, and then our begin block is ended by using end keyword, and then your language PLP JSQL, and this is your basic loop. I hope you understood the basic loop. Then our second loop is while loop. So while loop is similar to your C language loop. So what is while loop? In this while loop we can provide, or we can This while loop is used between block of statements until specified condition becomes false. So when at that time, whenever we our condition provided condition is false, then your loop is terminated, and until you can execute this loop again and again. So we can see the syntax. So while keyword is here, after that we can provided some condition, and whenever this condition is true, then you can execute this loop, and that's why this loop keyword is here. And after that loop keyword, you can provide some statements which are executed until this provided condition is false, and after that end loop statement is here because this basic loop is ended here. And for this is the example. We can create a function having demo, and this demo function returns a value integer, and after that in declaration section we can declare a x variable having integer data type which is assigned to value 0. Then your begin keyword is here, which indicates our procedural block is started, and after that we can provide a while condition is here. While x is less than or equal to 10, whenever our while is less than or equal to 10, we can provide we can execute this loop until this condition is false, and that's why this loop keyword is here. And after that loop keyword, we can provide some expressions, which is x equal to x plus 1. We can execute this statement x equal to x plus 1 until our provided condition, which is x is less than or equal to 10, is true. And whenever this condition is false, our loop is terminated, and then becomes to end loop statement, and after that end loop we can return x value. And then your begin block is ended by using end keyword, and then language PLPJSQL. So we can see how to control a program flow by using these conditional statement and control loops. I hope this video is helpful for you. If this video is helpful, please do like to this video. Also share with your friends. And you haven't subscribed to my channel, do please subscribe to this channel. Also share with your friends and family members, and hit the bell icon for such new videos. And I recommended you complete series of your RDBMS as well as Java. Then your testing tutorials is available here. And please let me know in the comment section on which topics you can want to watch the videos. I'll make sure to make the videos on that topic. For watching this video, thank you so much. Stay tuned for next video. In next video, we can see views in your RDBMS. So thank you so much.